Now we're going to talk about how to add links to your page. You may have agendas or other classroom materials that you would like to add to the page. And so the links are handled up here in the top row. You'll see that there's a different, like a chain link fence. This would be the link to an external website, the first one that's just labeled link. There's link to file. There you can upload a file and then link to it. And then there's link to a page. You primarily will be using these first two, okay? Linking to a page won't make a lot of sense. Unless you want to reference something on the district website. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is, if I want to link to an external website, you need to go pull that page up, okay, that you're going to link to, because you need to copy the address of that page. So I'm going to open up a new tab, and I'm actually going to link to the FoxBrite Support Help Desk. So I know the URL of it, and I've been there a lot of times, so I'm going to do that. And so here I am. And so if I come up into the address bar and I click up here, it should select all the text. I can then do a copy. Now I can come back to my page, and I can say, you know, FoxBrite Help Desk. And it's important to type in link names that make sense out of context for the screen readers. Very important for ADA compliance. Do not use the words click here and link that, because that doesn't tell anyone where they're going. It's very clear if I click on this link that I'm going to the FoxBrite Help Desk. So then I'm going to click on the link, and it's basically going to say, hey, where do you want to go? You type in this URL is for the address. So since I have that in my copied it, I can just simply paste it in. Okay. And I'm all set. I don't really need to do anything. You can leave the title blank. And so there, I've created my first link. If I want to link to a document, I'd simply, like, let's say I have an agenda for the class or a syllabus, so, and you may have multiple ones, so it might be good to include the date or the week that the syllabus is for, and I can't spell syllabus, which is, I'm going to spell it wrong, and there is a spell checker here, and I do encourage you to use it, so check spelling. So it's going to check it, and the first thing it didn't understand was FoxBrite. So I'm going to just ignore that because I know it's okay. And then syllabus. Okay, yep, it said, yeah, you spelled that wrong. And so I can just simply do the change too, and then it'll fix it for me. And then I'm done, so I can say finish checking. Okay, so so if I select my link again and then select link to file, it's going to give me the option to find a file. Maybe it's a district file I want to, but most of the time I'm going to want to add a file, and it's in the lower right corner. Okay, and then you will have a single category called My Files to upload your files to. So then if I select the New File button, it's going to take me out where I can do find some files. So I'm going to go back out to my training, and I'm going to go find a file in my training area. So I'm going to go find some newsletters. You pick your syllabus. Obviously, this is just, you know, a sample document. And then I just say OK. It's going to upload it. It's now been uploaded. It's actually picked it for me. And I can just say OK. And now this is linked. If you want to, and it's not necessary to, like if I knew that that was a PDF, I could put my mouse in front of that link, and there's in the middle bar here, there's an option called Insert Snippet, and this lets you insert like a PDF icon or what type of document that was. Okay. Now I've saved my changes, and it's always important to preview your changes before publishing. In the preview mode, you can test your links to make sure that they're doing what you expect them to do. And so it's opening up a document here. It's it, the one I uploaded. And so I can say, okay, I want to open that, and then I'll open it. Okay, and so that's it. And our next topic will be how to use expandable content blocks.